Here we have butadiene that's reacting with itself to make a dimer. This is a second order reaction in the concentration of butadiene. We're given the rate constant and the starting concentration, and we want to know how long it takes to reach a final concentration of 0.001 molar. Approach this problem, if we have not seen it before, always the first thing to do is write down the information that we know. So the rate of reaction is a rate constant times the concentration. And I'm going to use brackets to indicate concentration squared. We know the value of the rate constant. And we have our starting concentration. Let's call that 0.020 molar. Our final concentration, let's just use that notation, 0.0010 molar. And what we don't know is the time. What we're going to assume is we have the form for the second order reaction rate, how concentration depends on time. At the end of this screencast, I'll derive that formula. But for now, let's assume we have it. So here's the formula we're going to use, and we can substitute in the final concentration and then initial concentration, and then we can put the rate constant, and the time is what we're going to solve for. We can check the units, and units are going to cancel the molar in all the terms. We're going to end up with time in seconds. So I just multiplied this through, and you can see now 1000 minus 50 over 0.40 is going to be the time, 2375 seconds. The problem wants the time in hours, so 3600 seconds per hour, and we end up with a time of 0.66 hours, and we have two significant figures in our data, so time to two significant figures. So the question then would be, where did this formula come from if we were not given it? The rate of reaction, the change in the concentration of our reactant, C4H6, is equal minus the rate constant times the concentration squared, because this is second order. And then what we're going to do is separate variables and integrate. We worked with the integrated. This is the integrated form. So we're going to separate variables. This differential C4H6 concentration squared. And on the right side, we have this. So we could integrate both sides from time equals zero to the time we're interested in, and from our initial concentration, that corresponds to time equals zero, to our concentration at any time. So if we integrate, so the right side is minus KT when we substitute the limits. The left side is 1 over the concentration with a minus sign, we do the integration, between the two limits. And so we can substitute in the limits, and that's equal to minus KT. So we can rearrange this. Let's bring KT over to the left side. And so this is the integrated form that we used in solving the problem.